big writers that have created incredible shows. Julian Eisler went on, they created the middle. Amy Sherman Palladino,
who also went on to create Gilmore Girls.
Amy Jacobson.
Bruce Helford, who went on to create Nancy and Mary.
Chuck Lorre.
Dang, there's just a lot of them.
It was a great training program that everybody knew. If you survived those hits, you must be pretty good.
We owe a debt to more time than any.
And we have an Afghan on our couch. Yes. There's no lodge under there.
It's a little not Afghan on the couch. It's all it does.
I think that what Frankie and Roseanne have in common is they're not like June Cleaver as far as their families go. They're not wearing pearls and a dress with an apron. They don't necessarily always have a kind word or encouraging word for their kids. And not that they're mean, but it's just sort of a realism with your kids that I think a lot of parents relate to. Okay, did you have backpack lunch? I think what comes through in both shows is the heart and the love.
Just as it opened so many seasons around the kitchen table, Roseanne's last episode in 1997 included a final gathering of the extended Connor family.
The dining table is sort of like the hallmark of where everybody gathers for all important events, and I think that she used, you know, the kitchen and the table as the linchpin of all those stories, so it makes sense that you would resolve it all at the table.
The final episode shocked the viewers with revealing Dan's character was actually dead. And the entire last season, you know, where they were rich and won the lottery, it was all just a story Roseanne made up. None of it happened.
My writing's really what got me through the last year after Dan died. I think I'll be a lot better now. This book is torn.
The sad ending hit hard for fans and for the cast.
Their show was when I was devastated. Maybe one of the hardest moments of my entire life. If you can picture everybody you know that you literally have built your world around for 9 years, suddenly everybody has to leave.
It was strange to be only, you know, 22 years old, start back at ground zero and have to build my life back up after having early success.
The show ended, but life moved on.
So after the show, I did a bunch of other acting.
Is there anybody else here with you?
I'm alone.
And, you know, I go to movies, and I really focus on family. And I met my wife, and got married. I really wanted my kids to have some kind of normal life, and I wanted to be heavily involved.
Yeah.
And so, behind the scenes, I worked on the technical side of everything. And then, I was a high school coach, mostly baseball and softball. I guess I look at it because I never chased my dreams. And so, I kind of always love to help other people chase theirs.
I've been commuting from Canada, so I'm back there, did my JOM Arts degree, then when I was 24, I was like, okay, I'm ready, now I'll go back, and then got lucky with Scrubs, next patient, and then I'm staying. After the show was over, I did a few movies, and I just started to work again, do different projects.
Lucy Goranson finished college and continues to act in film and theater.
You go.
John Goodman's career includes dozens of blockbusters and independent hits. And Roseanne returned to stand-up, started a farm, and even ran for president.